I think I just want to read a few more verses from Habakkuk. I encourage you to read this, only three chapters. Read this book later. It's really a wonderful little book. Chapter 3, a prayer of Habakkuk, the prophet, according to hard name. Lord, I've heard the report about you, and I fear. Revive thy work in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make it known. The word revive here is a word that it could be translated almost, it's close to the phrase God gave me last night, recovery of breath. This would be more the recovery of life. This is one of the primary reasons why I said I would need to read Habakkuk or Haggai, because of this phrase, revive your work. We need a recovery of breath. We need a recovery of life.
Come on. Yes.
In wrath. What a phrase. In wrath, remember mercy.
Yes.
In wrath, remember mercy.
Amen. Yes.
We were at the White House, I guess it would have been Thursday night. Spent an hour or so praying outside. Had gone to dinner with several people, and someone had brought up a dream. And Greg was one of the people at dinner, and I think he had had the dreams. They brought up this dream. Said, God's been reminding me of this dream you had months ago. And I could remember parts of it, and I said, you know, give me a key word, I'll find it, because on my notes page, they mentioned a word, and I said, that's right, that was in there, and I found it almost instantly. And so I read it to the table out loud so we could all hear it again. And Ken Malone was there when I finished reading it. Ken said, I feel the Spirit of God all over this right now. We got to get to the White House and go now. Pray. I said, oh, yeah, I think so. It was like 9 o'clock night. We were only 2 or 3 blocks away. And they brought the check. $222. Several of us there, you know. $222. I said, I got it. I got it. I showed them the figure, and the, of course they all went crazy, you know. Oh, let's go, you know. $222. God does that stuff for me when I'm about to go on a very significant assignment. And of course, to a lot of people, that's a coincidence that you're reading a dream about going to the White House and you have to go do it. And then he gives you the number that is your life number. That's just a coincidence. But, you know, I knew what he was saying. Go over there and use the authority I've given you right now.
Amen.
22:22, Isaiah. And they all knew the same thing. So we went. And I tell you, the enemy will even help confirm for you that you're on assignment and you're doing well. Because we were standing across Pennsylvania Avenue in the little park, because they had Pennsylvania Avenue closed. So there were several people milling around, and we got far enough behind them where we could conversationally pray. Just looked like we were talking to each other, but we were praying and decreeing. And a couple came strolling along down this way and made a turn and headed by us, and when they got next to us, she looked at us and said, this is my neighborhood, not yours, and kept walking. And a couple of the people said, what did she do? You hear that? She said, this is my neighborhood, Did he think that was a demon? I said, uh-huh. You think?
What was your first thing?
You think? Maybe? That is awesome. When you're doing something like that and the enemy shows up and lets you know, I don't like this, you're accomplishing. Do you think if we were wasting our time, he'd want us to do it? Well, of course. So I said, that's a good sign. And then we're praying, you know, it's this opening doors, closing doors, dealing with things as we're led. And all of a sudden, the Secret Service, the police just walked over for no reason, just removed the barriers, opened the door so we could walk right up to the gate of the White House. And we all looked, they looked at me and said, he just opened the gate. I said, yep, another sign, we're right on target here. So we were able to stand there for about an hour and pray the dream. Amen. Cut off the head of the serpent. We're going to win this thing.
Amen.
Amen.
We're going to win this thing. It's time.
It is.
It's time. Read it all later. Maybe we're going to read the last few verses of the book. I heard and my inward parts trembled. By the way, I told that story because when he said in wrath, remember mercy, we were standing there at the White House where the mercy angel came to us in 2016. And we were talking about mercy and we were praying about mercy there. And I was standing right where the lady came to me in 2001 with the baby and reminded me of 2222. And that's a story that's just crazy. So we were standing there in that spot. And I said, this is where. And we talked about it a little bit. And then Ken turned around and said, and that's where we were when the mercy angel came. So he's remembering mercy. We're going to win this thing. Amen.